Welcome back to tonight's meditation session. So we are all gathering here at this time to practice meditation. According to the instructions by the Buddha, in order to practice meditation, says that we have to go to the forests or empty hut or under the tree where is less distraction, conducive for the practice of a meditation. So on this view, we are sitting in our house, basically minimizing any distractions as much as we can. If you are sitting comfortably, you shouldn't be having any other activities or running radio in your background, or turning on the television. And even you don't have to look at the screen that you are following now. You may close your eyes so that there will be less distractions. And one thing we have to remember that in the practice, we are choosing an object to pay attention to, and the distractions choose us, always pull us away, like an animal that I mentioned yesterday. Eye is also one kind of animal, ear also one kind of animal, nose, tongue, body, and even the mind, always pulling us from our intended object. So that's why we better to minimize, better minimizing any distractions as much as we can while we are practicing. But if you are skilled practitioner, then doesn't matter where you are, what type of distractions are there. Nothing will be the distractions, but everything becomes friends. But as we are simply practicing beginners, we better to have conducive environment and minimizing distraction as much as we can. And after we are free from distractions, we have to unbind our duties and responsibilities. So leave all your responsibilities and duties, the jobs that you are responsible for. So leave aside for a while during this time of a meditation, fully dedicating this time to learn yourself, the body, the feeling, the mind, and the phenomena. Fully dedicating this time to your own well-being. And then, after that, sitting comfortably, it's called upright position. Ujjunkaya panidhaya. So, sitting upright but not rigid, in a comfortable position, which you can keep in this position for the period of our meditation session. And remember, our mind can play a very good trick. No one is watching, so I can change. No one is watching, so I can stand up. No one is watching, I can move. No one is watching, I can do other things like that. So it can be tricky. So, making a good, wholesome determination or resolution that motivating yourself not to move but remain still. And once you are fully remain silent, this physical body in this moment here and now, the calmness and stillness of the body helps to collect the mind, to unite the mind and free from the restless mind. Normally we like to dive into the thoughts of the past or worrying about the future or dwelling into the jobs that we are doing, and which is another reason why again we can't feel ourselves, we can't relax ourselves, and we feel like we are lost. So as the body calms, the mind also will be in the present moment with the body. And with that, there will be less thoughts, less worrying. Mind also begins to calm and collect it, free from restless. At that moment, obviously mind needs an object to arise, because mind is always conditioned arose. Without an object, there is no mind. So we have to give an object to play with, to begin with. And rather than imagining, rather than verbalizing, rather than using any external objects, we are simply using the object which is embedded in us, the breath-related object. And we settle down on that primary object, whichever you have chosen to pay attention to, whichever object that you have decided to work with, whether the breathing in and out or the rising, falling in abdomen, or rising, falling of abdomen. And in a practice, we have to have a right teaching and then a right way of doing it and a right method, and only then we will get the highest attainments. We will achieve what we aim for in the practice. So these are the preliminary requisites that we have to go through every day, every time, every moment. And if you're really looking for the greater achievements and the development of your practice, not only the sitting moment that you are mindful of your actions, but beyond your sittings, that I normally call take the meditation with you, or take the meditation cushion with you in every walks of your life. The continuity, unbroken consciousness and observing the objects brings the happiness, and we will be able to break through, because when we meditate, we will be able to recognize different types of feelings. Bodily feeling and also mental feeling. And in terms of the bodily feeling, can be painful feeling or pleasant feeling. Similarly, mind also experiences pleasant or unpleasant feelings. Now, normally, when we experience pleasant feelings, we tend to grab and grasp and longing onto it and wanting it again and again. That's a greed. We desire it to happen again and again. And similarly, if that's a negative feelings like a pain in your legs, pain in your back, pain in your knees, and there is a resistance, negativities arises, and you want to push it away. And then, and that's a resentment, anger and hatred generates. So we will be able to recognize that too. At the time you may feel pleasant sensations like wow, happiness. Mind feels lifted, joy, enjoyment. It's like when you are with your good friends and you're having a fun. And you may be carried away. And you want it again and again, that memories. That pleasant and happy feelings. And again, other times you may feel grief, sadness, sorrow, pain in your heart. It may sometimes makes you cry, sadden, feel of loneliness. Those also arises. And we will be able to be mindful of that. And as we become mindful of these state, these feelings, we become more aware and see that these are just the temporarily. And we will be disconnecting ourselves from those feelings. But not rejecting, we simply accept, oh, I am having these feelings. And when you have a right attitude to those feelings become a neutral. Not pleasant or unpleasant. And you can be dwelling on that, the stillness of your mind. And you can enjoy that state of the mind too. And mind is unconditioned by these pleasant and unpleasant sensations. And there is no emotions. And we will be watching it objectively. And these state of feelings called Vedana become much, much clearer as our mind settles. And remember, we are not looking for those sensations. We simply notice them. We simply watch them as it comes and note, mentally making a note Each time when we see that, each time when we notice it, so it's like a hitting a nail. Bang on at all the time whenever it arises. When it arises pain, recognize that pain and mentally make a note of it, pain, pain. Unpleasant sensation, immediately recognize it, unpleasant sensation. So on. But if you feel again, mind is very restless, then again do not fight with it. Simply bring your mind back to the body, awareness of the body. Settle down, grounding yourself, finding object, working with object. Settling down your mind on the object, aware of the object. Be with the object, thinking of object, being with the object, and be one with it. And slowly again, expanding understanding of the feelings and the minds like that. So continue practicing until you hear the gong in this way. So practicing diligently with a great faith and confidence. Diligently. mindfulness meditation. So bring your attention to the body, aware of all the sensations. Observing objectively. And bring that attention to the hands, aware of the sensations in your hand. And bring that awareness to your heart and feel the beating heart and generating loving kindness and compassion to oneself. The Buddha said that whoever practices loving kindness meditation, in their mind is a deliverance of it, fully cultivated and developed, and living with a kind heart and compassionate mind in everyday life, using the kindness and compassion as a foundation, one will attain a certain benefits. Such as a sleeping becomes ease, nicely sleep, no difficulties in sleeping, waking up without any troubles, be free from any bad dreams, both humans and non-human beings will love or dearer, invisible beings always around you to protect. Further on saying that fire, poison and even the weapons will not destroy because of their mind always with the positive thoughts, easy to concentrate and finding the peace. The mind, not only that, a person who has got this kindness, his facial expression become serene and bright. There won't be any confusion. Further on, it helps to find the ultimate happiness. So it's a very important practice to build harmony within ourselves and then to others. This in mind, sharing loving kindness and compassion to yourself. May I be well. May I be happy. May I be at peace. Be free from hostility, ill will, animosity, anger, jealousy, ill will. And similarly, sharing loving kindness and compassion to all other sentient beings. Starting from near, dear one, acknowledging people around you, sitting next to you or in the house, in the community, in the city, in the country, in the universe, both visible and invisible beings, whatever beings there are, may they be well and happy, may they be at peace, may they be free from suffering. May they be free from hostility, ill will, animosity, calamities. May all beings be happy. May all beings be peace. May all beings be liberated, liberated. Bring your attention to your hands, awareness of sensations in your hand and to your body. As you hear the gong slowly coming out from meditation. Let's pay respect.